state, but they have a network. And the poor Russian state, they are the poor, all the ladies, widows, they were crushed, and many died. And so he solved the problem by brute force. He would go into villages and see whoever has a recoil from a rifle, a mark on the shoulder, gets pulled out and killed. Mm-hmm. You see, and because that means that this person had been a freedom fighter or whatever. And so he's thought about crushing the movement. It's not quite working. But I think the Chechen cannot create large-scale operations right now. It's mainly they can make attacks, local attacks with bombs in Moscow, and can create problems for the Russians. But they cannot. They don't have. It's impossible for them to fight an army the size of the Russian army. So. I think the situation has also evolved from Chechnya and has expanded into all of the Caucasus. But I think the differences in culture between the people from the Caucasus and the Russians are too large. There's the religious differences. They are Muslim. What Putin has done here, put in charge one Kadyrov, who is now the son of Kadyrov, and he's a Muslim, a devout Muslim. And they have built a big mosque, so there is the freedom to worship is there now. And this Kadyrov, again, is a friend of Putin. He's a friend, but I don't think Putin trusts him either, you see. And his father was part of the fight, of the first fight, and then started with the Russians the second time. So I think the Russians have situation that they have to deal with. I think in the end, these people will get their at least a great amount of autonomy, maybe total independence.
Because the Chechen issue came from Dubai, didn't it? It arrived in Dubai in Jumeirah Beach residence.
Yeah. We had one of the leaders assassinated with a gold-plated pistol, no less.
Really?
Yeah.
I know, yeah.
And mysteriously, his bodyguards disappeared, and he was left alone, and he was assassinated.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It happened to be on the day that Sheikh Mohammed visited Putin, so maybe it was just fortuitous timing.
I have a question.
Yes.
Why do you think it's that there is no coverage in the press at all? Is it just that it's...
No, there is coverage, and I think there is a lot, but the Western nations, Europe, did not. They allowed this thing to continue. They said, and there were some reporters that actually reported on these excesses, and they were actually killed in Chechnya. I forgot their names, but there were one lady was killed, and there were people killed in Moscow. The Europe. The position of Europe is that Europe is dependent on Russia for energy, for gas, for oil, and they cannot allow this conflict to jeopardize their source of energy. Mm-hmm. So they have given Putin a lot of warnings about these excesses, but they have not. Europe cannot go in there militarily or cannot impose sanctions on Russia. Russia is a big. Somebody said Russia is a country that when Russia is in trouble, it shrinks, and when Russia is feeling well, it expands, and it has not an easy because Georgia has problems with them, everybody has problems with them, and I think eventually. They have a big border with China. That might be something that they'll have to wrestle with in the future. But it's just speculation.
Could I ask, you're very talented, as you alluded to. You're a professor of material science.
I don't consider myself talented. It's a struggle through the day.
How difficult was it to get your book published and accepted? I mean, did your background help you because people knew that?
I find it difficult, yes, to go and do something like this. And I found a small publisher. My publisher is a small publisher from San Diego. It's a Sundell Publishers. And this lady, Jennifer Redmond. She published my two books, and it's limited distribution, and it's not a major publisher. I would love to have a major publisher take it on, but and I devote most of my energy to my career as a professional career, so I have not really pushed that far enough as I could.
Do you think it could be adapted to a film, screenplay?
Yes. Yeah, I think so. It has these elements in it. I think so. Because it has a lot of visual things. A lot of people love violence, right?
Bangs.
Bangs. Yes. Bangs. And it has quite, so I think it has this potential. But, I mean, there are hundreds of novels out there, thousands maybe.
And how has it been received in Chechnya? Have you any feedback?
I have not sent it to Chechnya. I have no idea about Chechnya.
Maybe you shouldn't.
I should have it signed in Russian. I should translate, have it translated into Russian. So.
Yeah.
I have a question. You're talking about how the arms go back and forth, the drugs and the arms through America to Mexico. I was having dinner with a gentleman from Baghdad who's lived all his life in Saudi. When he went back, he's been back for the last 5-6 years when the Americans came in. And of course, he hates them. And saying how porous the border between Syria, basically, but the whole border, when he came through Damascus and went right in and, you know, told the driver, take my passport, and the guy said, no, you don't need it. He went there for 21 days, came back, and I said, you paid a bribe. He said, no, you can. So the idea, is that the trend, that everything is so porous, that what you see, people can take in guns, can take in nuclear,
I think actually the border with Mexico is being really closed, and there are people, they are building a huge wall there.
Mm-hmm.
And it's becoming, but it used to be very porous. I remember so well when I used to go to Mexico with Mark, we used to go, and we used to go to the Mexican side, and the Mexicans were just waiting there across the border. There was a big wall, and they would just wait till it got dark, and they would just jump over after dark, and they would run, like 20 of them run, and then the border guards run after them, they catch 10, but 10 get away, and then these 10 that they catch, they have to take them back, so they try again, and they try, and so, but now, I think they're becoming, I don't know exactly where this will all go, it's very politicized, and then the illegal Mexicans that are in the United States, they say that they are not illegal, they are undocumented. And they are becoming a big force. But then the Hispanic population, some of the more established Hispanic population, they look at them, they don't like them either. They say, look here, we worked our way, we are Americans, and then you guys are here. So it's a mess. Now, to go into Mexico, it's still like this because I was with Linda, and then I just walking across. Before you know it, you are in Mexico. They don't check your passport, nothing.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't it? You come by car and they say, come on, you can load there, you can fill the bigger truck with weapons and then walk and then run to Mexico.
Apparently what he was saying is that during the Saddam Hussein reign, it was also very, you know, barbed wire, guards and all that, but the common denominator and the most easy point is that the people don't guard.
To go into Mexico is easy, but to go into America is very hard.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
You see, in one direction, it's because they know that nobody wants to go into Mexico.
Sure.
And in America, there's a line to go to America. There's a line that takes 3-4 hours to make.